Curating content for your second brain can be a challenging task, especially when you're away from your computer and you have the best idea ever. Sometimes it can be hard to capture that immediately.
I've just had the most brilliant idea, and I must save this to my second brain before I forget, but I don't have a journal or pen. But I do have my smartphone, so I will record a voice memo to save this idea to my second brain. Create an automation that will use ChatGPT to transcribe my voice memos and add them to my Evernote second brain. And create title and tags for the note in Evernote.
All right, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to build the automation that he was talking about. Not sure who that was. I will show you step-by-step how to automate the conversion of voice memos into Evernote notes, complete with a title and a tag. Just a note here, if you're not using Evernote for your second brain, you can easily add this to Notion or whatever it is you use for your particular second brain. This automation will use make.com, an automation platform, and ChatGPT, an AI platform you've probably heard of. And if you need to create a Make account, check out the description below for an affiliate link that helps support my work on the channel and that gives you a free month of the core plan on Make. Let's dive into this automation. But first, my name is Andy O'Neill and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. Check out the video description to subscribe to my newsletter and to see links to the awesome tools that I use in my no-code workflows. Also, please hit the thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel if you like content like this. First, let's talk about capturing those audio memos on your phone. I use an app called Easy Voice Recorder Pro, and I'm going to show you the setup that I have for this particular app. You can use a different app if you want, but the key here is to get it to automatically sync over to a Dropbox folder or a OneDrive folder or that kind of thing that will make this process completely automated. All right, so I've opened up my Easy Voice Recorder Pro and it is ready to record, but I'm gonna click on these dots right here in the top right corner and I'm gonna click Settings. So we're gonna click on Files, we're gonna click on Cloud Upload there at the top. And I'm going to connect this to Dropbox. You can see there you can connect to Google Drive, Dropbox, or OneDrive. I'm going to click on Dropbox, and it's going to have me authenticate to my Dropbox account. So it'll go over here to a screen and ask for permission. I'm already logged into Dropbox on my phone, so it won't cause any problems. I'm going to click Allow. And now you can see we've got Dropbox connected. If I click on the gear there, you can see we're going to auto upload new recordings, upload only over Wi-Fi, and that's where you can remove your account. So that is my setup. One more thing I'll show you in Files is the default name. You can set this. So what I've done is I put in the date here and the second brain that typed in the second brain and the number of the memo. It gives you a lot of freedom to choose the file name that you would like for your memos. Okay, so we're over here in Make. And I've created a scenario already. I'm going to walk through this scenario. And again, you can go download this scenario from my Gumroad store and install it right here and kind of skip this build process. But I'm going to show you what's happening in this automation, which will be important if you do that. Okay, so our trigger module, our first module here, is a Dropbox watch files. And you can see I'm watching. I've got a folder in my Dropbox called Second Brain, and I have an Easy Voice Recorder Pro folder here, and I'm not watching subfolders. It's important for this process to create a folder dedicated to this. So my audio from Easy Voice Recorder Pro is syncing from my phone directly to this folder and nothing else is getting in this folder. All right, click OK on that. You can click Cancel. I've got a little filter here that says File ID exists. The reason we have this is this is going to check for files and there's going to be times it's not going to find anything new. So we want to make sure the file exists before it proceeds, because otherwise it's going to try to run this scenario with blank data and that's not going to do anything. The next thing we have to do is we have to retrieve that file from Dropbox. So our trigger is watching for new files. This one will download that file into Make. Next, we're using a create a transcription whisper module in Make. And this is pretty easy. We can just map this right here to the Dropbox. Basically, what's going to happen is we're going to send our file to ChatGPT's Whisper transcribe tool, and then it's going to transcribe it and output the transcript. So here is Whisper 1 is the only one we get, and you really don't need a prompt. It will transcribe because that's what it's made to do. I've got three ChatGPT items in here that are working with that transcript. The first one is generate action items. So what are the action items from my voice memos that we need to do? We need to do this, 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 that kind of thing. This is generating action items. This one's going to create a name for the note in Evernote. And this one's going to create tags. And we're going to put all these together with the audio into an Evernote note in our second brain. All right, so let's take a look at this one. This is a create a compilation GPT module. Just a note on this and the Dropbox. If you're using Make for the first time, you'll have to click right up here on Add to create a connection. So you're going to need to establish a connection to Dropbox and to ChatGPT using their API, and to Evernote or Notion or whatever you're using for your second brain. So we're gonna select a method, create a chat compilation. I'm using GPT-4, and we're gonna do a system prompt here. And this just says, create a list of action items from this transcript and summarize them formatted as a sentence. Format the list with one sentence or action per line. No HTML or text formatting. And then the text here, we've mapped the text that is coming from our transcript module, so our transcript of our audio. Next, we're going to create a note name. This is pretty easy. Same setup as before. Create a succinct and meaningful Evernote note name from this transcript text. Next is tags. Same setup here for ChatGPT. Our prompt is, create a comma-separated list of tags that are relevant to the content in this transcript. Output the tags on one line, separated, I'm going to do a little editing here, separated only by a comma, generate no more than 8 to 12 tags. I'm just going to say 8 tags. Sometimes ChatGPT listens when you tell it how many to make, sometimes it doesn't. Okay, so I'm going to unlink the Evernote module, and to do that, you right-click and say unlink, and then we're going to run this manually and see what these items create. So I'm going to go over here, right click on the trigger and say choose where to start. And then I'm going to choose manually. And then here is the file, most recent file we want to use. I'll click OK. And then I'm going to run once. So it's going to run all of this with that one file that I selected. All right, so here is some results. So this got the file. It sent it to Whisper. Here is the transcription of that note. So it's creating a summary and our action items, which I like that a lot. So next we're gonna go to create a note name. And our result, animating voice memo transcription via ChatGPT to Evernote. Makes sense to me, and I'm gonna leave that. And let's look at our tags. So our list of tags here. ChatGPT, voice memos, Evernote, second brain, transcription, automation, AI, note titling, tag creation. Looks great. So I'm going to connect this back up here and let's take a look at building this Evernote. Again, you can use Notion, whatever you're using for your second brain. So the title here, we're going to look at the title. So our result, this is outputting quotations around it. But what I've done is I've got a replace function here. So I'm saying replace and I'm putting this message content. This is the message content. Actually go down to choices, message, and content right there. And then I'm saying for the double quotes, replace them with an empty string. So I'm just doing a find and replace and saying when you see quotes, replace them with nothing. All right, down here in the content of our note, I'm going to use some HTML, which is actually going to work in our Evernote note. H2s is what I like to put in here. So I've got actionable items, and then I'm going to put the action items right here. So I've got this mapped here. Go down here to message content right there. There's our action items. The next thing is the transcript. Again, another H2, and I've dropped the text of our transcript right here into that. Escape HTML characters, that needs to be set to no. Otherwise, it's going to strip out my H2s and it's all going to be normal text. So you're going to set that to no because we want to keep our HTML. Next for our tags, we have to make this an array, which is a data format within Make that that contains multiple items. So what we're going to do is we're using a split function. Then we're putting our other comma separated tags. And what's going to happen is these tags are going to get split by a comma and turned into an array, which will tag these on our note. So I always put Easy Voice Recorder Pro as a tag plus whatever tags ChatGPT has generated. If you want a default tag on here, you would just add another one and put a comma behind it, and that would add that one on all of those items plus your generated tags. I'm going to leave this as it was. We're also going to have our audio on the note. I'm going to add it there as an attachment. It's really handy because you can go back and play the original audio and maybe edit and change some things in your note. All right, so let's run this start to finish and then go over to Evernote and look and see what it looks like. I'm going to right click on this again and say choose where to start. I'm going to select that file there. That's our newest file. And then in a second, I'm going to hit run once. I'm going to show you real quick. I have this running every 2 hours, Monday through Friday, and from 9 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. You can take this advanced scheduling off and just have it run every hour. You can have it run every 5 minutes, whatever schedule you want to do. But right now, I have it every 2 hours on those days. All right, so let's run this, and we'll jump over into Evernote and see what it looks like. All right, we're over here in Evernote, and here's the note that was created by our automation. There is our title. Here we have actionable items. You'll notice actionable items also came through on our ChatGPT items, so I'm just going to delete that out. I could probably update that prompt to not put those in there as well. So here's our action items. Here's our summary, and here's our transcript. And you'll notice here's our audio. We can play this right back.
Create an automation that will use ChatGPT.
So there is our audio we can play and our final note. I hope you have enjoyed this video. This is a powerful automation that can help anyone who's building a second brain dictate ideas or even dictate long form content over to their Evernote. If you want to dive deeper into the world of make.com and ChatGPT, check out this playlist. It has tutorials that will teach you how to use ChatGPT in automations. If you ever need help building make scenarios for yourself or for your business, head over to weblytica.com and book some time with myself or a member of my team. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.